Good evening, YouTubers. Thank you for joining me. Today is October 1st, 2022. It's currently 45 degrees there at Yellowstone. Yeah, they got some snow on the mountains on the higher elevations. And here we got a live view of the Old Faithful webcam. They've had several earthquakes today that are actually reported, the largest being a magnitude 2.8 earthquake. Yeah, it was near Haugen Lake, and it occurred at 3:39 p.m. local time at a depth of 13 kilometers or 8.1 miles below sea level. They don't have a moment tensor ball for this. Going to Google Earth, here's location of that 2.8 earthquake, and let's bring it out. Okay, here we got Haugen Lake, and this very well could be related to the Haugen Lake fault zone. I've been looking into this Red Canyon fault zone and the swarm up over here that's been ongoing, trying to find a name for this fault zone. This very well could be the Red Canyon scarp. Not much research has been done into this area, and I've spent all day trying to find out about this scarp. Yeah, and it goes all the way up to Bozeman, Montana. And here you can see it encloses Haugen Lake. Let me make this bigger for you. So I'm going to be looking some more tonight about any research that's been done on this area. Someone is on the ball tonight. They did not fudge about this earthquake. It comes in as a magnitude 2.83. This is the Maple Creek monitor. The borehole 207 was working earlier today, then it stopped working. So I am down to four monitors. I opened up a new one to try and get more information, seeing how the borehole wasn't working. Here we have Soda Butte, Holmes Hill, and CLT, Little West Thumb. That's why I always call it Little West Thumb instead of West Thumb. But anyways, yeah, there's the earthquake, and there's been other ones more recently. Here we have the live stream view. At the top is Maple Creek. The one underneath it is Little Thumb Creek, or Little West Thumb, as I call it. The next one down is Soda Butte. Notice here, Little Thumb Creek. Yeah, it's screaming. And then at the very bottom, let me bring it down, that's Holmes Hill. Yeah, look at all these quakes coming in. So let's go to the largest of the most recent. I'll have to make that bigger. Okay, right there. That comes in as a magnitude 2.33 at 22:23 universal time. So that would be about 5:23, 5:24 mountain time. And then we got another small one right afterwards. But the next one is marked in red, which is that one right there. That would be at 5:25. Local time, or 22:25, that comes in as a magnitude 1.66. All right, so this one right here I already did, and let's do the next one that's marked in red at 20:41. So that would be at 3:41 p.m., and it comes in as a magnitude 1.91. And we'll go to its signature real quick. It's got quite a P wave on it. When I was going through the files and downloading them, I noticed this one right here at 1:27. This would have been universal time. It occurred in Peru. Because if, let me just pick whatever. I'll just, let's pick Soda Butte. See how deep that is? Yeah, and there was a magnitude 4.7 there in Peru. So I think that's what it was. and it shook up the caldera here at Yellowstone. Let me go, let me go up and check out some of this other stuff at Soda Butte. Now at Soda Butte, when that 2.8 earthquake came in, yeah, it shook up Soda Butte and it made it scream. Look at that right there. Let's go to the spectrogram. See that? No data came in. Blank. Let me go back to the seismic monitor. Yeah. And see, this is way over. Let me go to Google Maps. Over on the northeast side of Yellowstone Lake. All right. We got Soda Butte right here. And then we got Soda Butte Campground. Let me bring it out a little bit farther. They had flooding in this area when they had that big storm earlier this year. And this part of the park, the roads are still closed. So Soda Butte is up over here. And then keep an eye on that. Yeah, all my writing. And then down over here is the Sour Creek Resurgent Dome. This is the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome. And that's Yellowstone Lake. So let's go back to the area where the magnitude 2.8 earthquake occurred. Yeah, I thought that was really interesting that this earthquake would shake up the caldera so much over there at Soda Butte. Okay, just look for the little blue pins here. Yeah, that it would make it scream all the way over there. So let's check out Little West Thumb. Now you can see afterwards, yeah, we had blobs of magma coming in. Let me make that bigger for you. Yeah, that's their actual scientific term, blobs of magma. See that, how the melt line rose up right after this earthquake? Let's bring it over and you can follow it right there. And then we'll come, almost went off the line. What's it currently showing when I pulled the files? Right there. And we got a small quake there. And the other one there, which I already showed you on the other monitor. All right, 9:39 a.m. Or excuse me, 9:31 a.m. local time. Yeah, you can see we got magma that was coming in there at West Thumb. Let's follow the line of melt. See that? And let's jump up over here. Let's see what else we can see at West Thumb. There was no earthquakes during that time. All right, we got something right there. So we got one here at 1:02 universal time. That would have been 8:02 p.m. last night. And then we got another one at 8:36. Yeah, you can see the line of melt here. And then let me pull it over. We got another one over here, right there, at 8:28 p.m. And yeah, you can see there was magma coming in. Remember, there's that dike, that crack where it's trying to come up there at Yellowstone Lake. Let's take a look at this. All right, let's go back to Soda Butte. 11:39 a.m. See that signature? And this is Soda Butte. See that? Let me bring it over and see if I can see anything else. Went off the line. Okay. 19:25 universal. So that would be 2:25. And let's go to the spectrogram. Some of these are really hard to see. 11:32 p.m. last night. Yeah, quick popping of the rock there. See that? 11:26 p.m. last night. Yeah, it's interesting that this is just like right in the middle. Okay, I think I did that one already. And let me come down a little bit more. Take a peek, see if I can see anything else. Like I said, it's hard to see. Well, I'm glad I downloaded the data when I did. Yeah, look what's going on with the live stream. Look at all that empty data. Let me bring it over. Yeah, we got another earthquake coming in, or it did come in. Yeah, it's all been removed. Now, isn't that odd? Well, I've often talked about, and other people have brought up, the fact, can they remove data? Well, there's your proof right there. All right, so I was going to go through some of these small ones here at Maple Creek. This one here at 2231 is a magnitude 1.69. That would be at 531. I don't know if I did these or not. 530. Yeah, I think I did. 534. Yeah, okay, and this one more recently. 605. That's a magnitude 2.34. Looking here, when I pulled the files, you can see the different little pockets of line of melt. And a lot of people have brought up about people walking here around at the park. Do they realize how close some of these pockets of melt are? I did find documentation that there is pockets of melt only 600 feet below the ground. So that's a little less than 2 football fields. You know, I can't say they had a temporary power outage because the data was here earlier. And you guys saw that. You saw that for yourself. So it was removed. So what are your thoughts? What do you think about that? Please put your comments down below. Like, share, and subscribe. If you wish to support my work, I'm also on Patreon. Thank you for all of you that do. You can subscribe for just $1 a month. Yeah, thank you very much for all of you that do. All right, well, yeah, interesting today. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.